Hi, in this video I will go into more detail about finishing the edges with a slip stitch border, and I will go into detail specifically on the edges. In a previous video you have seen me doing crochet borders, and I was doing crochet borders, and you know, I was sometimes wondering, because there is an issue, and I have tried to make it clear in this drawing. Well, as you can see here, this is a sketch of weaving. You start here and then you go to here, and then you go around the first two nails and you go back. And when you're finished weaving and you will count the side loops, if you have a loom with 10 nails, you see here that you have 9 loops, because you have here, you've gone around the first two. You can see here you have 9 loops, you can see here you have 8 loops, and you can see here you have 9 loops. Well, when doing my crochet borders, the first thing I always do is make here and here a temporary loop that I will take out when I finish my crochet border. But what about to do with this corner? Because what I would really like is to have something like this, that you have 10 on this side, 10 on this side, 10 on this side, and 10 on this side. Because that is so much easier when you want to crochet or attach pieces together, when you've done your crochet borders and have the same amount of stitches on each side. So that is what I will do now. First of all, you start at corner A, so that's here, this corner where you have the loop around two nails, and I will just show you. Let's start. So here is the weaving that I did, and as you can see here, this is corner A with the loop around two nails. So I will start like usual. I've done my weaving with two threads, so I will do my crochet border also with two threads. And I start with making a slip stitch and put it on my needle. And then I will just start making, I will put it on my lap against the table, because that's a nicer working position. I will do my crochet stitch here. And as you know, with slip stitches, you go right away through the loop. And this is my first stitch, and I will take it out for a moment, because what I really like to do, and that will really, really help you. You see here, this V shape here, and this is my first stitch, and I will mark that stitch with a colored thread. You can also use stitch markers, but I've used up all my stitch markers, so I will just use my my thread, leftover thread. So, because you know, when you mark it, it's very easy to count. When you finished your side, to check if you have touched all your nails with stitches. And later on, when you make several pieces together, then you have, then you just have a sign where to start. So, okay, I've done my first single crochet around the first nail. And now I will just continue like always to the next corner. This was the second one. This is the third one. Okay, and I will continue with this till I've reached the other side. I've reached my corner B. I've done a single of a slip stitch around this last of second to last nail here. So I've done the slip stitches around 23 nails, and you can check that by counting the V stitches on the side. So this is number one, where the thread is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. And here in this corner, you have this thread that you ended with. And like I told, I will make a temporary loop that I will take out later when finishing. I will put it on the table. And it doesn't matter if you go under, over, which part, it doesn't matter. You will take it out anyway later. So, I will make my 24th stitch in this corner. And then I will move over to the other side and I turn my weaving frame. And then again, I will go through the same loop. And this is your first stitch of this side. And again, I will mark it. So when counting later, I can see where to start counting. So I will go through that loop here. And I will make a knot in it. So that is number one. And then I continue with crochet around number two. And I will go on like this till the other side, and I will meet you there again. Now I've reached corner C. I have done my last slip stitch around the last border loop here on the drawing, that is this loop here. And again, this is the thread where you started to weave. There was a slip knot originally around this nail, and I took that off, and because it's a slip knot, you can easily pull it out. And then again, I will make a temporary loop around this corner. And I will just weave in a little bit. And again, I will finish and take this thread out later when finishing. So, the first single crochet slip stitch around this one. And now you can see you have 24 stitches on this side. This is number one, where I marked it. Number one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So we go over to the next side. So again, make a slip stitch around that same corner nail and mark that also. That was the first nail, second nail, and I will continue and I will see you back at the next corner. So again, I've reached this corner D, and as you can see here, I don't have to do something extra. Well, I will count my stitches. I've done 23, if it's correct. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. So I will go again around this last nail twice. So this is the last one of this side. And then I turn my loom a little bit, and I will, sometimes it needs a little help to get through the loop. And this is again number one, which I will mark. Oh, my watch is stuck. Okay. And then I will go back to corner A again, and that is where the magic happens. And well, I will see you when I'm back there. I've reached corner A again, and when we started, I did the first stitch around this corner nail, and now I have done 22 stitches around these 22 nails, and we can check that. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, and 22. And well, the first thing I do is make this 23rd stitch in this corner loop of this, yeah, this corner loop. And probably you think, well, why not make that 24th also here? But the moment the weaving gets off the loom, it draws in a little bit, and I don't want to do a lot of crochet in the corners. My next video will be about doing single crochets on the edges, and there I have something worked out that I will show you why, and I also show you there why I don't like to do very much crocheting in the hoop in the corners. So okay, I've done my 23rd stitch here. I cut off the yarn and I pull it through right away, so don't make another stitch. Pull it through right away, and as you have seen in my previous video, I like to do a kind of invisible ending, and I will do that with my needle, and that will create that 24th stitch that you are still missing. And I have to show that clearly. Here is the first stitch you made. And you see you have this V shape here. And now I will go with my needle through these two V shapes, these two legs of the V shape. And I will pull my yarn through that. Okay. Things get tangled up here a little bit. So I went through that, these two legs of that V shape here, and then I will go back. I will take, get this out of the way. I will go back into that last stitch I made here. So through the center of it. And now I have created an extra V stitch here. So now it's ready to get it off the loom. Well, when you do crochet and you make squares, you probably know that usually in the corners you make extra stitches. Well, I didn't do that here because of two reasons. First of all, the slip stitch is very close to the weaving. And it's not a very high stitch. So, okay, it didn't feel necessary to do that. But you also see this same weaving is made on this loom. And that you see there is quite some drawing. Because even with this border around it, it's smaller than it was originally on the loom. So when you look at it, you know, you see it really isn't necessary to make extra chain stitches or do extra stitches in the corner. It is just enough to make two stitches in each corner. And now you have 24 stitches on each side. So if you have several pieces and you want to make them together, it's very, very easy with counting. And also if you mark the corner stitches, here I marked both the start and the end, but well, that will make life so much easier for you when putting everything together. Okay, I hope I made it extra clear in this video. If you like my video, I would really appreciate it if you give it a thumbs up. And if you'd like a comment, I would also like that. If you have questions, you can also do that in the comments. And well, I would really like it if you would subscribe to my videos, to my channel, so that if I have a new video published, so you will be noticed right away. So thank you if you would like to do that, and I will see you in the next video.